decided to make another vlog. There was some discussion or postings on the Endless Fear Forum about legalizing certain bikes and that, and what to have legal and what not. Obviously, you got to have a power assistance sticker. What I've been doing is trying to make it better for me. Obviously, I had to shorten the axle because the ears were sticking out so far. And then I ended up epoxying the rod in there. It still could break loose if I wanted to. But it keeps them straight. So if I take a sharp corner, these don't drag on the ground, which they were doing before. But what I ended up doing is I ended up taking off the chain, which is a bad idea because they can actually get you for that. So I'm going to show you how to do a quick mod where you can fasten this where it's not dragging, and you can leave the chain on and it'll freewheel in both directions, which is basically what you want to keep it legal. It's got to have pedals, sticker, chain. So what we're going to do is we're going to remove this cover here, which is just a matter of taking a screwdriver and a hammer, and you sit it in that little groove there, and then tap it loose this way. And what will happen is all the bearings on this side will fall out. What I'm going to do is I'm going to tape the sprocket to the wheel. That way it doesn't fall out and all the bearings on the other side go as well. Once I get this off, I'm going to reach in with needle nose and pull out the two little fingers that are in there. They're ratchets, and it makes them go one way. Once those fingers are removed, it'll freewheel in both directions, and I can put the chain back on. So, first thing we're going to do is take that off, but we're going to have to tape it up before we do that. Okay, the tape doesn't have to be that nice. It's just basically going to keep it from falling out and all the bearings in the back falling out as well. So as long as it's tight, it should be good. To remove the race, you just basically put the screwdriver in there and give it a tap. As you can see, some might be tighter than others. This one was actually pretty loose, so likely would have came loose and fell apart anyway. We just have to, I'm going to grab a container and put it underneath to catch the bearings as they fall out. Fine there, but I'll show you how to put them back in. I don't think you could do it if they fill out the other way, so that's why we got it taped up. Just doing all this without taking the wheel off, which you do not want to do. Oh yeah, these bearings are going to fall right out. You can see them. To get them back in, what we're going to do is we're going to use bearing grease. And then we're just going to put them all back in by hand. A little bit time consuming, but it's going to be done. If anyone's rebuilt them, you know what I'm talking about. Okay, so it's out. And then what you're going to do is you're going to take this, there's going to be a lock ring in there. Remove that. And I think that's it. I think I can see one of the little ratchets there. Hopefully I should be able to pull it out with needle nose pliers. Set this up with some more light here. Let's do it. That's better. There is one ratchet there. I should be able to pull that right out. There it goes. That's what, lets it go one way, but then ratchets the other way. You should be able to just pull that out. I don't even have to pull out the lock ring that's in there. Well, I don't know if I can get the other one from here. Might be a problem. You can even see it. Okay, the other one's going to be a bit of a pain because it's right behind the swing arm. I'm going to see if I can dig it out without messing up the sprocket. Oh, it's right there. Try from above. I didn't say it was an easy mod. It's going to make all the difference in getting a fire or not. I'll do it. Well, let me get the other one out, and then I'll show you how to repack it. Okay, well, both of them are out. They're in the container there. So what we're going to do now is we're going to take a little bit of oil and put it around in the race there. So when we put the, I'm assuming we put this back on, it should be good to go. It'll be nice and smooth, and it'll just free roll on both ways instead of the one. Put the lock rings back in. Go. So what we'll do now is pregnant it with some oil, and then take our little bearings and slowly place them back in the race, which is going to be time consuming, but I'll bring it back when I get them all in there. A little tedious, but can be done. We got the bearings back in, just about ready to put the lock ring back on it. So good. And the bearings on the other side didn't fall out, so it's all good. Just got to make sure when you put this back on that the bearings don't bunch up. Tape off. There you go. Free wheels in both directions. Perfect. And then all you do is you just take your hammer and give it a good couple of good hammers or pounds just to tighten the lock ring up. Good to go. All the bearings have stayed on the other side. Free wheels on both sides. I hope that helps, guys. Let me just throw the chain back on and show you how legit it looks. There you go, guys. The chain is back on. That's why they can't nail me for that. I got pedals, I got the chain. Free wheels in both directions, so now I can back up the bike without worrying about it making the pedals turn and everything else, which is a major pain. So now it's a really good setup.